There is no doubt that getting into the housing market in Australia is extremely difficult. Just to ask the cast of Five Bedrooms.
Yeah, in season one, we saw five singles who were seated at the same table at a wedding buy a property together. Now they're back for season two. Here with all the goss is one of the stars, Stephen Peacocke. Apologies, Steve. How are you this morning, buddy?
Very well. How are you going out there?
Yeah, we're great, mate. Thanks for talking to us. It looks like we're speaking to you from a set. Is there something you'd like to tell us?
Well, look, there's nothing I can confirm or deny at this point, but yes, we might have a bit of news for you tomorrow, maybe.
Five Bedrooms and one trailer. Hey, season two of Five Bedrooms is out today on Paramount Plus. We're very excited. What can you tell us about season two?
Yeah, well, it picks up in a really good spot for the five of us. We've sort of got rid of the old place. We have to find a new place, and first episode's kind of launches off there. But my character, he's in a pretty good place. He's got himself a good woman. You can see on screen there, I get to play opposite Doris Unane, who's one of my favourite people to work with. I know she's fantastic, and I get to work with her a lot. And, yeah, there are a couple of new relationships, a couple of accidents, a couple of pregnancies, maybe, I don't know.
Close cast.
Maybe. I'm trying to remember. It was a year ago. But it's great. The writing's fantastic again, and... it was just such a great show to work on. We actually got shut down halfway through when the plague hit last year, and we got to pick it up again and finish it, and it's just turned out so well. So we're thrilled that it gets to launch on Paramount Plus today, tonight.
So you would have been doing a bit of filming during the pandemic, I'm guessing. Does that mean no pashing?
Definitely not. There was just a lot of COVID tests right before we did. No, it was remarkable. I didn't know how we were going to do it, because I think we were one of the first productions on the planet to go back into to get back to work. And, you know, we shot on location in a house, and of course you can only have so many people in a room, and anyone who's been on a film set knows there are 20 or 30 people, you know, from electrics, lighting, everyone setting up cameras. So we had to slow everything down, but somehow we got through the same amount every day, and the crew were fantastic, and yeah, we got it done, and we've seen them all now, and they're so good. We're so proud of what we've done.
Your career is just absolutely soaring. The industry, though, has been through it's been through the ringer over the past couple of years. Let's face it, everyone's sort of been affected by this global pandemic. Despite having to make a few tweaks to filming Five Bedrooms, how else has the past year changed for you, changed kind of acting in the industry in your eyes?
Well, look, globally, it's been, the brakes were sort of put on everything. I had mates that were, had landed cool gigs overseas or wherever it happened to be, and they weren't able to work. But thankfully, because, I don't know how we're doing at the moment, but we got off to a pretty good start last year, so we were able to shoot here, and there were lots of productions heading down here to work, and our crews down here, our directors, actors were all pretty world class, so it was good in Australia. But certainly overseas people took a hit, and I was talking to my agent the other week over in California there, and he said, I don't think I've got any other actors that have worked solidly through a pandemic the way I have. So I feel very fortunate to have gone from just pure luck and scheduling working out, gone from job to job to job. So, look, I feel very, very lucky. But, yeah, lots of people are doing it tough, which breaks my heart. I'm from a family of small business owners, and, apart from the obvious tragedy of people, being sick and losing loved ones, I just can't bear to see people going out of business for something that, they had no control over.
Yeah, no, it really is terrible. Talking about taking a hit, being in the spotlight means you sometimes become the subject of criticism and take a few hits. Is not being on social media a great way to handle life in the spotlight?
I didn't kind of make a conscious decision. I'm just not really a very public person. I don't have many opinions that I feel are valid to share with lots of people. So, I've sort of dodged that bullet, thankfully. But it's good, it must be nice to be able to look at Twitter and see people enjoying your work or those things. But I find it's easier just to stick to learning my lines and enjoying my time off the screen privately.
Oh,
telling
awesome.
People what you had for breakfast in person rather than posting a photo to prove what you had. Yeah, that kind of thing. Well, Paramount Plus is streaming now. You can head to paramountplus.com.au for your 7-day free trial. Stephen, thank you so much for joining us. We're so excited about season 2 of Five Bedrooms.
Thank you. Yeah, we're excited too, and thanks for the support. And it's lovely to chat to you. All the best till next time.
Take
you
it easy.
You too, mate. Take care. Keep kicking goals.